4-6, multiplying fractions and mixed numbers. Multiply and rewrite in lowest terms, 2/5 times 7/8. This here also should be a straight up review for the first part of the lesson, and then we'll make it just a little bit more exciting as we go along. The first thing you want to do is simplify before you multiply. Now remember, when you're doing this, that you can simplify vertically, up and down. You can also simplify diagonally. That's okay. But what you cannot do, under any circumstance, you cannot simplify horizontally or side to side. Notice it's in red. You can't go there. Don't go there. Don't even think about going there. This is one of those slap yourself things for thinking about going there. Don't do it. When you look at this, you say, well, will 2 and 5 simplify? No, they will not. Well, will 7 and 8 simplify? No, they will not. Well, how about 2 and 8? Yes, they will. 2 goes into 2 once, 2 goes into 8 four times. How about 5 and 7? No, they will not. How about 5 and 4? Will they slap yourself? Don't try it. It's horizontal. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to multiply numerator times the numerator. That's the top ones, which is going to give you 7. Denominator times denominator, the bottom ones, which is going to give you 20. Simplest terms, you're done. Easy math. If you simplify properly before you multiply, you should not have to simplify after you multiply. You pause it, do that one. Alrighty, for here you've got 8 and 9, will they simplify? No. 3 and 4? No. 8 and 4? Yes. 2 goes into 8 once, 2 goes into 4, excuse me, 2 goes into 8 twice. Let's try it again. 4 goes into 8 twice, 4 goes into 4 once. How about 3 and 9? Yes. 1 goes into 3, 3 goes into 3 once, 3 goes into 9 3 times. How about 3 and 1? All right, you thought about it, slap yourself again. Quit thinking about doing horizontal. You can't do it. 2 times 1 is 2. 3 times 1 is 3. Circle your answer. Done. Easy math. Try that one out on your own. All right, the only thing you can simplify here is the 2 and the 4. It becomes a 1 and a 2. Multiply it out. 1, 6. Circle your answer. Dang, this stuff's so easy. Ooh, that one's a little more exciting. Try that one on your own. See if you can find them all. Simplify before you multiply. All right, hopefully you paused it and did it. The obvious ones is going to be the 50 and the 25. But there's another sneaky one in there. Sneaky, sneaky, 7 goes into 49 7 times. 7 goes into 28 4 times. 25 and 50, that's a 1 and a 2. Multiply the tops and the bottoms, going to give you 7 eighths. Circle your answer. So did you find them before you did multiplied? I hope so. Would have made that problem a lot easier. In the event you have a problem with whole numbers and mixed numbers and fractions all in one big happy ugly family, you want to convert all the mixed numbers and whole numbers into improper fractions before you do anything. You have to do this. You cannot work it without converting to improper fractions. So we do that. The 12 became 12 over 1. Over here we did 4. 3 times 4 is 12 plus 2 is 14. And that's where the 14 came from right there. Gave me 14 thirds. Simplify before you multiply. Well, the 12 and the 3, that's obvious. That's going to go, which means we're going to simplify those, becoming a 4 and a 1. And hey, look, across the top here, you got even numbers. You can simplify that too, right? Slap yourself again. Quit thinking about doing horizontal. You can't do it. So instead, just multiply 4 times 14 is 56. 1 times 1 is 1. 56 over 1 is 56. Circle your answer. If you need to, change that answer to a whole number or a mixed number. If it's a proper fraction, you can leave it alone. If it's an improper fraction like you have right here, you gotta do step 3. Easy math. Here's another shiny little problem. Two mixed numbers. Gotta change them both to improper fractions. We did that, of course, by 4. 7 times 4 is 28, plus 2 is 30. That's where the 30 came from. 5 times 1 is 5, plus 2 is 7. That's where the 7 came from. Now we're going to simplify. We can simplify lots of things here. The 5 goes into 5 once, 5 goes into 36 times, and these 7s, they're going to pop each other upside the head, knocking them out to become 1s. When they do that, you get 6 over 1, otherwise known as 6. Easy math. You're building a tree house that has an area of 6 feet by 5 and a third feet. What will be the area of that floor? Well, by is a fancy mathematical term for times. So we're going to get 6 times 5 and 1 third feet. Change them to improper fractions. Simplify. The 6 and the 3 are going to knock each other out. Hey, look, even number. Now you just thought about it again, didn't you? Pop yourself again. Don't do it. You can't simplify horizontally. From there, we're going to take 2 times 16 is 32. 1 times 1 is 1. But the magical part, feet times feet, is, remember, feet squared. Don't lose your units. If you lose your units, you will get an Easy math. Circle, you take that 32 over 1, make it just 32. Circle your answer. Your homework for this assignment is worksheet 4-6. Now, by this point of time, some of you may be starting to run through this chapter like the critter is in this upcoming video that I have for you. You see what happens when you're not focusing on where you're going. Remember, you're building on where you've been and moving towards where you're going. Don't be like the antelope. I will.